Only moments away from Bitcoin's third halving. What can we expect for Bitcoin's price in the coming weeks? We got a crucial close for Bitcoin's price last night. Now, what does that mean for Bitcoin heading forward? Is this one of the potentially most bullish setups there has ever been? With that being said, is there a Bitcoin price chart hinting at one more drop below 8K? Before we absolutely moon rally? In addition, Paul Tudor Jones estimated at over $5 billion of net worth on CNBC this morning, calling Bitcoin a great speculation, saying he has almost 2% of his assets into Bitcoin. He has a lot of great things to say about Bitcoin, so we're gonna be going through that. And as well, Bitcoin having interest is absolutely to the moon. So much going on, guys, you need to check this out. And as well, limited time only, the Ledger S wallet is 50% off to celebrate the Bitcoin halving. If you're interested, check out the pinned comments below. Huge. Wow, and as well, one of the biggest CME gaps in history, but not to the downside, it's to the upside, which is much more bullish. We're going to be talking about that in this video as well. What can we expect for the next week of Bitcoin's price? Let's get into it. What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another extremely exciting episode of Bitcoin. Probably the most exciting day for Bitcoiners in a very long time, guys. This is huge. The third Bitcoin halving, by the time you're watching this, it may have already happened. It's huge. Now, the effects will definitely not be seen within the next 24 hours. It'll not be immediate. This is a long-term thing for Bitcoin to get excited about. In fact, many people are still forecasting potentially a little more downside before we absolutely rally into the future, but that's what's important. The future holds so much for Bitcoin. There's so much positive stuff that most likely will come out of this even before the end of this year, guys. It's a huge, huge deal. And if you guys were watching the charts last night and you watched yesterday's video, we did get a crucial close, and we'll explain what I think this means and how good this could be for Bitcoin. Ideally, what we want to happen with the price over the next 1 to 3 weeks would be awesome here. So guys, a lot to get into in this special episode. So if you're new to the channel, make sure to smash the comments, the dings, the subscribes, and the likes to enter for this. We'll actually choose this winner in the next episode. But guys, a lot of you comment, and there's no way that I can afford to give everyone that comments a free Ledger. So for a limited time only, Ledger's website is actually selling these Ledger S's for 50% off. All you have to do is put in the code WEARETHEBULLRUN at checkout and you get 50% off, guys. $30 for a Ledger. Now that is a good deal. So make sure to check out the comments pinned below to get one of these bad boys if you definitely need one. I recommend keeping your crypto safe and keeping it yours, and that means putting it inside of one of these bad boys. So guys, we have a lot to go over with the charts, we have a lot to go over with news, everything, but as you can see here, let's actually give this a little refresh because it's changed a little bit. So yeah, it actually jumped ahead 20 minutes. It was falling back a little bit, now it's jumping ahead. So only roughly 4 hours and 40 minutes until the Bitcoin halving. As I'm recording this, 30 blocks left, and the halving is gonna be at the 630,000th block. The block reward will decrease from 12.5 to 6.25 Bitcoins, okay? Absolutely massive, guys. 2012, 2016, and now 2020. Absolutely insane. This is going to be very interesting. So let's start off with the charts here, you guys. So as you can see here, this is the weekly chart. Now, what I was talking about in yesterday's video was this. Now, this is not a perfect spinning top, as you can see here. If it would have closed right around maybe even like 89 or 9,000, it would have been like perfectly even, but it is good enough in my book to be considered. So the reason we talked about that is actually because we had something extremely similar after exactly 7 weeks of rallying during the last massive rally, 7 straight weeks, and then a spin in top, some indecision candles. Okay, keep in mind these are a few weeks of indecision and just consolidation ranging in a certain area, and then absolute blast off moonshot. So here we have a very similar setup. Now, I'm not saying that is exactly what's going to happen here, but I do 100% anticipate within the next few months, I 100% anticipate Bitcoin absolutely smashing above $14,000, if not the all-time highs, and at least approaching the all-time highs. Something very sharp. I expect something like this even, okay, guys? Could be very massive. So this is not going to happen by tomorrow or like 2 days from now, okay? This is a little further out, but still definitely within, you know, a very tight range, okay? It's definitely this year. As you can see, we're still actually, as we've been talking about since right here 2 weeks ago, this MACD cross is still developing pretty nicely, you guys. Even with some recent downside, we've had some dumps, some pretty small dumps comparatively, you can see here on the 4-hour chart. But overall, this momentum is building up very nicely. So we could even see, we could be seeing a rally within the next 1 to 2 weeks, okay? A very strong rally. That would be absolutely bullish. So everyone knows the sentiment surrounding Bitcoin. Everyone is expecting a dump, and we're gonna get into some details with that as well. But Bitcoin likes to do the unexpected, and we've already had a substantial dump right here, guys. 9,700 down to 8,100 in just very short, quick candles. Now, coming back to this 6-year line that we have talked about, we're still holding. Currently, we're above that, okay? We've been really fighting for support here, and I definitely think that's important. We've been doing very well there. If we switch to this daily chart, you can see as well, we're bouncing off the 21 weekly, you can see on this chart, and also the 200 daily moving average. But also, you can see we critically bounced right here on this descending line right here. And I think, ultimately, we are very soon going to get a bounce out of this. Finally, once and for all, we've been in this since the summer of 2019. I think we're finally soon going to get a bounce out of this very long-term downwards channel, which is also a part of this gigantic symmetrical triangle. And again, guys, I definitely think within the next few months, it's going to happen quick, and we could see a nice burst towards that. Maybe our first test of getting out of this, okay, within the next 1 to 2 weeks. Okay, what I mean by that is a bounce here and maybe up here and then testing it down for support. So what that would mean is breaking 10K and then coming below 10K again, similar to this, but maybe a little stronger. And then instead of just going straight down, continuing up, guys, that could be huge. In terms of this massive symmetrical triangle, we are now within the zone in terms of how long this has been playing out where we could get a break, okay? We've had multiple touches at the bottom, okay? About 3 touches on the bottom, and we've had about 4 or even 5 touches on the top here. So everything is met. We could be seeing a macro burst of this 2.5-year pattern much sooner than a lot of people realize. And as well, currently we're still fighting in the golden pocket of the last 365-day Fibonacci retracement. Right in here, guys. I'll just circle it for you. We're at the very top of it. A break out of that could actually push us back to try and retest 10K, okay? I think there's a lot of momentum building, and especially we've already had a halving dump, so I think a lot of people think, well, maybe there already is a dump. My point is, the point of this analysis is a more longer forecast, you know, a few months down the road, even just a few weeks. But guys, things are ramping up. Things are building up perfectly. These are the perfect scenarios. So let's get into some of these other details, because there's a lot going on. A lot happened today in terms of fundamental news for Bitcoin. And guys, before we do, we're also doing $60 off T4. If you want to learn about technical analysis and if you want to join, now is the time to do it, guys. This is the biggest sale we've had, $60 off. You want to learn about altcoins. You want to learn about divergences. You want to learn about returning patterns. Guys, there's so much in here. And when you get it once, you have it for life. So guys, let's actually jump into this CNBC article about Paul Tudor Jones. He was on CNBC this morning. So this is massive. He's estimated to be worth over $5 billion. He's in the top 150 richest people on the planet. Hedge fund manager Paul Tudor Jones said Monday he believes Wall Street could be witnessing the historic birthing of a store of value in Bitcoin. He says it's a great speculation, which it is. He's got over 1% of his assets in Bitcoin. He actually estimates almost 2% of his total assets into Bitcoin. He also defends Bitcoin, saying versus other stores of value in the US, like the US dollar, they tend to diminish in value over time as governments spend more than they generate. Bitcoin cannot do that, guys. So he's definitely a Bitcoin bull now. He's a longtime hedge fund manager, and he believes Wall Street could be witnessing the historic birthing of a store of value through the popular cryptocurrency Bitcoin. He was on Squawk Box this morning. Just today, Monday morning, I've got over 1% of my assets in Bitcoin. Maybe it's almost 2%. That seems like the right number right now. Every day that goes by that Bitcoin survives, the trust in it will go up. That's what he said. He talks about cash. If you talk about cash and you think about it from a purchasing standpoint, if you own cash in the world, you know your central bank has an avowed goal of depreciating its value 2% every year. So in essence, you have a wasting asset in your hands if you have the US dollar. Guys, this is actually happening. Billionaires are coming out and actually understanding Bitcoin. 2 years ago, this almost seemed like a fever dream, okay? People did not expect that this could ever happen, but now it's happening, okay? The biggest people in the world are coming out and understanding Bitcoin. It's absolutely beautiful to see. When he thinks of Bitcoin, look at it as one tiny part of a portfolio. It may end up being the best performer out of all of them, he says. I kind of think it might be. So he's saying here that he thinks Bitcoin might be the biggest performer of his entire portfolio. Guys, if that's not bullish, you know, I don't know what is. So let's take a look here. Michael Van De Pop on Cointelegraph saying about a sub 8K, and it's kind of similar to the TA we've been saying over the past few days. We can't deny this, there is usually a sell the news concept when it comes to big things, especially something which is the biggest in Bitcoin's history, the halving, definitely the biggest event that happens to Bitcoin every 4 years. So expecting a dump is not something that we can count out. It's actually expected, okay? Everybody's expecting a dump. We had a small dump. And not even small, within, you know, minutes dropped $2,000 basically. So could we get another one? It is very likely here. For all the previous halvings, the peak highs occurred before the event took place. So according to this, and according to data, the highs were actually reached before the halving. Okay, so they kind of dumped into the halvings. So honestly, what we'll see is maybe something like this, a curve upwards, and we're already heading towards that part where we're curving upwards potentially. This is my favorite part because this is what I personally expect, is that the price barely moved and continued ranging for afterwards. So basically, during the halving, not much happens. It just kind of trudges along and ranges in the same similar area where it kind of goes sideways for a little bit before then continuing to go up. And honestly, based on the chart that I was showing you here on the weekly, that's what I would hope is the best case scenario, is this even a slight dump or just ranging sideways before then continuing upwards. I think that's the best case scenario and the most likely scenario. And again, this retrace is completely normal. The market has seen an increase of more than 160% in the last 7 green weekly candles. Retracements and corrections are more than healthy for sustainable growth, especially when the hype around the halving passes. Okay, so the bullish scenario here is basically holding above 8,000. So if we go to this chart, I have this box as like where we need to hold. As you can see here, we're significantly above it now. In the very bottom of this box, the one that I personally think needs to hold is 77 to 7800 US dollars. So it's the very low end of the box, but ideally what we need to hold for a decent retracement and get a very, we could potentially see a very nice recovery and bounce going into the rest of the year, 77 and 8,000. Absolute lowest, I would say, is the high 6,000s. But if we start breaking, I would say if we broke below like 63 or 64, that would be very bearish. So we would not want to break anywhere under 6,500 US dollars. So guys, absolutely huge. Thanks so much for watching. Again, drop your comment because we'll be giving this bad boy away in the next episode. But remember, only one of you can win. So guys, definitely advise you to take advantage of this deal. 50% off, 50% off for a limited time. All you have to do is put in the code WeAreTheBullRun. And as well, guys, if you're interested in learning more about TA, enter the code HAVING at checkout for $60 off. Huge celebration around the world. Let's enjoy it. Wow. And as well, guys, potentially the biggest news that I want to save till the end here. Look at this CME gap here. We have this gap from about 89 all the way up to over $10,000 that we formed during the weekend because of that big drop. Look at this gap, guys. Does this also mean that we're going to be able to fill this gap over the next few days and come up and maybe even shoot past? This could actually propel us maybe over 10K yet again, but maybe for good. Okay, we always talk about gaps to the downside, but this is a huge gap to the upside. This is amazing, guys. What do you think about this? I personally think this is a very bullish indication for the next 1 to 2 weeks.